Hey, what's up, everybody? GMrDrew. Again, haven't posted in a while. Haven't been home actually, so just didn't have the opportunity to be working. I'm trying to adjust my camera. I'm working on another, getting sidetracked. Working on another small sketch, like I did the Mikey. Want to get this one done faster though. So, you know, maybe there's a chance this will be a quickie, even though I have about 2 hours before I have to go to sleep. Not have to go to sleep, I shouldn't say that, but before I ought to go to sleep. And, so yeah. What I'm working on, something I've been thinking about that I wanted to work on, and then I kind of saw an opportunity to work on it, and I'm taking it. It's not exactly the best idea what I'm doing, but whatever. What am I doing? I'm drawing a if you guys maybe have heard of a thing called Crunchyroll. Well, that's what I'm working on. Some Crunchyroll stuff. They have a One Piece contest going on. I found out about it days ago, and I just haven't been home. I finally got home tonight, and you know, there's 3 days left in this contest, and nothing major. You just get to like a subscription and maybe like a gift box or something like that, which is cool. I'm down with it. What else are you gonna do? Whatchamacallit for a contest? So it's kind of what they're doing is it's a One Piece contest. And I've had this picture that I wanted to draw of Roronoa Zoro for a while now. It's a picture I'm sure everyone's seen of him. Asura, he's doing his Asura move, where he kind of like takes on this six-armed form, and considering the fact that he holds 3 blades at a time, him in his six-armed Asura form, he's carrying 9 blades, and I remember the first time I saw this, I was just like, oh, this is the most, you know, badass thing I've ever seen. And, you know, the fact that he carries, you know, 3 swords at a time, or uses 3 swords at a time, wields them, whatever you want to, whatever verb you want to use. When I was a kid, first watching One Piece, I was like, oh, that's hardcore, especially when you find out his background story when they get to that point early on. I was like, man, I like this guy's determination. That's why he's one of my favorite characters. Is much like Luffy's whole gonna be the king of the pirates determination. Zoro's gonna be the number one swordsman deal is, you know, makes me always think, like, hey, I'm gonna be the number one artist. That's what. So I've always liked it. Plus, you know, Zoro's a badass. He's the badass of the whole pirate crew there. For sure. I mean, really, I only. Sometimes I only watch the show just to, you know, just to see what he does next. So what the contest is to take a screen capture of one of your favorite moments and just recreate it and redraw it however you want, your interpretation. So I'm not going to be doing too much craziness, and obviously I'm not, like, drawing it majorly big or working on a larger sheet or anything like that. Not that I don't want to. I figure I could always get to that later. So this is more like a sketch for me for later on when I actually draw the one that I want to draw. So it's a good sketching fodder. I've been thinking about drawing this picture for a while now, and so I'm kind of glad to do it, no matter the size, you know. You guys able to make it out so far? Yeah, it's kind of coming through. So, yeah, man. Trying to get along with this as quick as I can, but obviously that's what I'm always trying to do, and I'm always spending more time than I want on pictures. So chances are this is just going to be another exercise in futility. If I can make it in time for the for the contest, that'd be pretty dope. And now, do I expect to win? You know, since I'm working on such a small medium? Well, kinda, you never know. May not be about the size of the picture, you know? Or the fact that I'm just working on it when it's so late. It's a lot of lines. A lot of lines to consider. A lot of swords being drawn here. But y'all know me. Love drawing swords. I'm actually working on a project right now where all I'm going to be doing basically is drawing swords. So looking forward to that. As soon as I finish my brother's search and rescue piece and get the sleeve, that tattoo sleeve design done, loving it so far. That's what I'm talking about, man. Just work on the things you like to work on. Draw the things you want to draw. You know? What else you gonna do? Draw stuff you don't want to draw? And feel like you wasted your time and sit there and wish you had worked on something else, you know? Do what you want to do. I want to work faster. I want to draw this picture. The only thing with this picture is it happened at a time before he got his sword Shusui, whatever you want to call it, which was the one of the demon curse swords, the one with the badass blade on it, with the like the red teeth on the blade. So badass. See it yet? Starting to form for you? Maybe. Perhaps. Possibly. Trying to get all my perspective straight. it's funny, I got some replica swords. They're actually like metal and sharp and all that, but they're still just replicas of Zoro's swords. I got all four of them, even the one that rusted out, the one that's in this picture. And it's funny, the one that's supposed to have that flame on it doesn't have it in there, man. I feel like I'm missing out. I wouldn't mind getting like actual recreations of these swords that actually work, that I don't have to sharpen. Cause right now I got some grit stones to sharpen these things. You know, if I have to. Coming out. So far, so good. Feeling it. I'm feeling it. I'm loving it. you are. Start messing up now. Funny, I'm looking at the picture on the actual the screenshot of the episode where this is going on, and strangely enough, oddly enough, it seems like the perspective is like way off. I mean, obviously it's kind of okay. One, it's a cartoon, so it all happens in passing. But yeah, because he has these arms sticking straight out while all the other ones are bent. Or the ones like in the middle are bent. And since you can see the inside of the underside of the palm, like where the pinky, you can see the underside of the pinky where he's holding the sword, that means he's not extending the swords in the middle forward. Extending them backwards, but in the image the blade still rests in front of his hands on the arms that are on the bottom that are extended forward. Really weird that the perspective works like that. I mean, in the show, not to get too hard on it, but in the show, I mean, it's an loose illusion move where, you know, it's kind of like he has the bad guy, you know, the giraffe guy, kind of tripping. So it kind of makes sense. It's an illusion, so you don't have to. So I guess it's okay that the perspective isn't, like, spot on or something, you know? Yeah, it's all pretty sketchy right now. It'll all get cleaned up, especially when I get to the inks portion of this. Gotta tell you, man, a lot of people don't like One Piece because, oh, the art is too, like, cartoony or something. But, man, they do have a propensity for detail, you know? Like, even though it's cartoony, like, they still fit in every detail of, like, this guy's swords. Like, I mean, sure, the swords are important to this character, so maybe when you draw them, maybe, people are going to screen capture it and maybe get all the details in there. Okay. But still. I gotta sit here and draw all the details to this, to these goofy graphics. Not looking bad. You guys can see it, right? always thought was whack. What happens to the one sword that Zoro loses, that was got rusted out, was the way he lost it. Didn't even lose in anything special. You know, he just, like, gets attacked by random Navy soldiers, and this one Navy soldier just happens to have eaten, like, the rust fruit or whatever, and just corrodes Zoro's sword off-rip. He's just fighting a non-character. And it's like, your shit's rusted. Done. Sword's done, son. Time to retire it. And then he, like, stops to the two-sword style. What happened? Did it happen at, like, Water 7 or Enies Lobby? Happened in one of those places. And, yeah, man, I thought that was weak, son. Lots of details in this, man. It's ridiculous. How long have I been recording? 50 minutes. 50 minutes on the sketch already? It's almost an hour. Almost an hour, and I've got, like, almost nothing done. I jumped right into this one, too. I don't think I've really stopped at all. I'm enjoying this, man. I knew when I saw this, I was like, man, I'm gonna have to draw this one day. I don't know when I saw that episode, but it would have been like years ago, I think. Sometimes you just can't get something out of your head. You gotta draw it, man. Wow. You know, I didn't think I was gonna get too close to the original image, but this ain't that bad. Lid's done for. Come on, lid, don't fail me now. I know I hear some in there. There you go. New lead, reload. Whew. Alrighty, folks. Almost there. At least with this sketch. Where am I at? Hour 5. I'm done with the Zoro sketch thus far. Now what I want to do is draw the Asura figure that's behind him. This will be quick though. I have, right now it's the 22nd, I have until the 25th to finish this thing. Not that I want to wait that long. Something I just want to kind of get done. I believe it's already midnight. Normally I would be going to sleep, but don't know. I feel like I've been doing plenty of that lately. Thank you. go, that's it for the pencils. It is an hour and a half just to draw this tiny little thing, but you can see all sorts of detail in there. Why doesn't this thing focus? You know? Is my focus off? I'm gonna play with the camera a little bit. No, see? It's getting more unfocused. That help? A little bit. So yeah, Asura Zoro pencil sketch. I think I'll post this and I'll probably get right into the watercolors really quick. I don't know if I'll be recording that, just because it's going to take way too long to post this and do that. So, I don't know. GMrDrew, thanks for watching.